and be able to share that with my daughter. And I think, you know, she's really been such a great teacher for me, and I for her, and we've really got this really amazing bond that it's fantastic.
We're both reflect the theme that I think most people don't realize, and to me that theme is that happiness and problems have no relationship.
And just being happy with little things, you know. When I remember Jason coming home one day, and there's myself and the two girls, and we've got the stereo flat out, and because we were dates on the first, you know, just be really naughty. You get up on the coffee table and you just go for it, you know, have a really cool time. And you can be happy in that moment, or you can sit on the couch thinking about all the stuff that's going on that's not great, and you can be happy any time you want to be happy. And I didn't realise that before. And I think by coming through the whole process that I have over the last couple of years, I've realised that happiness is a choice. You can choose to be happy or you can choose to be sad.
How have you grown through all of this? Because you see how your lady's grown, but how have you grown?
I can see how that two people can actually make things go from, you know, no good at all into great, better than it was when you first met, sort of thing, you know. It is possible, as long as you're both on the same page. You know, you've got to be both there. You know, your support person is as important as the person with the problem, really.
How many years have you guys been together?
18.
18 years are better now than before, and I like that.
Awesome, that is so cool, isn't it?
That's wonderful, wonderful.
That's awesome.
And how about for you? I know that part of your vision, I understand, is to help other ladies that are having challenges.
Yeah, that's huge for me. I've got enormous big dreams. I'd really like to have a beautiful centre for kids and for families, so that they can come together as a family and have some support for the kids with special needs and the siblings and the parents, because there's just no support there that we've been able to find. Spending much more time with the kids, you know, we have our weekends free now, and Jason spends a lot of time off on the weekends, so we actually have time to connect as a family, and you know, we do some goofy stuff. We went down for a photo shoot, didn't we, only a little while ago, and we went down to the beach down in Brisbane. It was such a hoot, middle of winter, and here we are dressed in all the jeans and stuff, and we ended up having this massive water fight, and we were swimming in our jumpers and jeans, and oh god, it was amazing. We had all these people standing on the pier looking down at us, you know, and this one lady called out and she said to me, oh, wait till summer and I'll do that. And my instinct was, you know, summer may never come for you. This is our summer. It doesn't matter because it's cold, you know. We were throwing balls, and a lady brought down a puppy for the kids to swim with, and I had another lady that brought down crystals and said, could you wash them for me, because it's like, it was just a crack up. And there we are sitting in a coffee shop dripping wet and drinking hot chocolate. It was just beautiful. Now we haven't done goofy stuff like that for ages, but it was just wonderful. And the kids, I think part of what we've managed to really create here is some really good modelling for the kids as well. And I think the ability to share with them that you can make mistakes, because it's human to do so, but you can bounce back, and it's how you work with those that matters, you know. That's really important to us. So, yeah.
I can't imagine a better environment for your children up there. It's magical. So I'm excited for people to see the transformations you've created for each other and for your family, and hopefully they'll be inspired and remember what's possible and remember the past and not equal future.
That was one of the things that I...
Whisper to me, I'll tell you.
I knew I'd leave this bit to the last bit. I never had the chance to say thank you. And I really wanted to say thanks, because I just didn't get the opportunity to say it. You know, I can't describe to you how different life is for me these days, and I really do appreciate it, so, yeah.
Well, I want to tell you something. The greatest things that I could possibly have is to see the joy that you have, and also what brought me to tears here at the end. I'm already so moved by you guys, but I know what kind of life your children will have, no matter what, but this is their reference base. They may get off target, but when they have this as a reference base, you've given your children something that is immeasurably valuable, and you've touched the future beyond yourselves. And, you may really do it there, but please get me out of my mind. All the thanks in the world is just to see you guys so happy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Jane. Thank you. She's got amazing family right here, too.
Thank you.